Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm making rice cake Alfredo creamy tteokbokki. So if you guys want to know how to make this, please hit that subscribe button and watch me cook. But before I move on, I want to say thank you to all of you that reached out to me through social media because, you know, mom life kept me really busy and my daughter is doing great. We still have more appointments to go to. But again, thank you. So this is the simplest version of this recipe you could come up with, and I hope you guys like it. All right, the first thing I'm doing here is using scissors, obviously, because really I just didn't want to wash my cutting board. So I just grabbed some tongs and a pair of scissors and I chopped away. We are going to be using this to decorate our food with later, so all you have to do is just chop these up into bite-sized pieces. This is the same kimchi, but I rinsed it. I just made sure I took off all the red peppers and anything red just to turn it white like this because I didn't want it to change the coloring of my food. So again, my scissors, wash that off, and the tongs as well because again, I don't want any remnants of any of the peppers. But we're just gonna chop these up into whatever size pieces it is that you want. And we are going to be using this in our creamy tteokbokki. Next, go ahead and grab your meat of choice. I chose to use my leftover bulgogi that we had for dinner the other night, the Korean barbecue beef. Just using this and cutting it all up into small bite-sized pieces as well. We want about a cup's worth of meat. So if you want to use chicken or shrimp or mushrooms even, just to keep it vegetarian, go ahead and do so because really this will work with any of those. If you want to skip it all, you can. If you just want to have the rice cakes, again, it's a really easy choice. It doesn't have to make dinner hard. If you have it, use it. If you don't worry about it. But whatever it is that you choose to use, just use about a cup's worth of it and that's it. Now, read the scroll, the little crawl that's going along here. Do not skip the green onions. This is going to help enhance the flavors toward the end because we're gonna put the raw, chopped up or cut up like I'm doing here, green onions on top to decorate our food with, and it just helps with every bite. And just trust me on this, don't skip it. Just cut it up and you're just gonna put it right on top when we're done. And no, I haven't tried it with chives because I don't feel like it has a lot of flavor, so, or compared to green onions. So I'm gonna stick with green onions on this. So if you're curious, stick with the green onions. Now I have two different kinds of rice cakes here. These are smaller little, hate to say it like this, but they're little rice balls. And the cylindrical type, but this is a thinner one that you can find. You can find different kinds in the store. Just go with the thinner one because they're gonna cook faster in your pot. I am using a very large pan here. About a tablespoon of sesame oil is all that I'm using for this part. You know your pan's ready when the sesame oil will spread easily throughout your pan when you move your pan around like this. Now I am using a larger pan for this, so all I'm doing is going ahead and throwing in my white kimchi, the plain rinsed one, and my beef. You're gonna cook this for a few minutes. Basically your meat is heating up and you're gonna have your kimchi turn a little translucent. I think it took me about, what, 3 to 4 minutes or so with the sesame oil, and just mix it around your pan until you see that it is translucent. Next, I'm gonna be grabbing my rice cakes. I'm gonna show you the packaging because it shows it in grams, 500 grams, and the next one is gonna be 400 grams, which basically equates out to about 3.8-ish. So I guess 3 3/4 to 4 cups would work fine with this. But all we're gonna do is go ahead and throw both of those packages right into the pan. I'm just shaking it around a little bit, not necessary, but just go ahead and throw them all in there and make sure you get all the stuff that comes inside of there out, the silica packets. You don't want that, obviously. And the next thing we are going to do is just go ahead and just give all of this a good stir. See, good stir. I'm just making sure all the rice cakes are just mixed up and the beef as well as the kimchi, again, just all stirred up. We are going to let this cook on the pan for about 5 minutes. You want 5 minutes of this, and just stir it occasionally to make sure nothing is sticking to the pan. You'll notice as well, after the 5 minutes, you're not going to see a lot of that oil left inside of the pan because it's going to be all on top of your rice cakes as well as the beef and the kimchi. And you can see how it's dried up on my pan a little bit. And you're gonna see that it's a little bit toasted here. And I think it kind of helps with the texture of it all. I like it this way personally. I guess you don't have to do it, it's not necessary, but I think it's good this way, so I'm gonna stick with that. So after the 5 minutes, go ahead and grab your Alfredo sauce. Again, store-bought will work. I just use the original kind, nothing with any kind of flavoring in it or additional flavoring in it. And if you want to you make your own, you can, because obviously you can make a gluten-free kind. There's a keto version out there as well. Whatever you prefer, go with it. Again, I'm using Jarred because I want this to be an easy, quick dinner. And this was, I believe, done in like 15 minutes altogether, mostly because of my chopping and then the 5 minutes here and 5 minutes there of food cooking. Once all the sauce is in there and you have everything nicely mixed, go ahead and make sure you empty out those jars because you don't want to waste any of your sauce. And then all you have to do is cover it up with a lid. Now, my pan is large. So if you have the same issue with me and you don't have a lid for your pan because you didn't buy one with the lid, or you just, I don't know, you don't have anything that'll go ahead and just cover on top of that, be like me and use aluminum foil. Let me show you. Just grab a sheet of aluminum foil that's large enough to cover over your pan. Make sure that you have it where it's folded down so all the steam gets trapped inside, because you want to be able to cook the rice cake through to make sure that it's soft when you're done with your meal. And that's it. So all you have to do is just garnish it with the kimchi and the green onions right on top and go ahead and serve. 15 minutes or less. If you guys like this recipe, please make sure you hit that subscribe button, like it, share it, and until the next meal, thank you for watching. Watch me cook.